How to create amazing splash color effect with color replacement tool in Photoshop. Welcome to PS Desire Photoshop and Photography YouTube channel. In this photo effects tutorial, I will show all about the color replacement tool and how it helps us to converting the overall photo into black and white while leaving color of a particular subject or object in full color. Many people try using adjustment layers like fine-tuning hue and saturation, adding black and white layer, and then mask the unwanted areas using brush tool. You have all the skills you need to achieve this effect, but in here I show you method to get the effect without any selection tools at all. That's right, you don't need any skills to get this effect. First, duplicate background layer. Select color replacement tool nested under the brush in the tools palette. If you learn mastering this tool, it's a very powerful to change the colors without a lot of fuss and hassle. With the color replacement tool selected, your mouse cursor will change into circle with a small target symbol in the center of it. Color is the default blend mode and will change both the hue and saturation. The brightness will remain unchanged. This is the blend mode I will use most often. Each of these icons represents a different sampling option, work exactly same as background eraser tool. And from left to right, we have continuous, once, and background swatch. The default setting for the limit option is contiguous, which means that can only change the color of the pixel in the area the target symbol in the center of the cursor is touching. The opposite of this is discontiguous, which allows to replace the color of any pixels that match the sampled color and fall within the boundaries of the cursor. Now select foreground color to replace color. To change the foreground color, simply click directly on the color swatch. Then choose a new color from the color picker. I will choose a black color for color splash effect. As you drag the cursor over your image, Photoshop continuously samples the color that is directly under the target symbol in the center of the tool's cursor. This is the color that will be replaced, and it will be replaced with your current foreground color. You can see that effect applied within the circle surrounding where center point of the cursor is touching. To change the rest of the photo to desaturate, I just need to keep my mouse button held down and continue dragging the color replacement tool over the remaining areas. Press the left bracket key to make the circle smaller or right bracket key to make it larger. Now face of the subject is key here. It contains colors which is similar to his shirt color. To color the tricky beard hair, choose one sampling option point. With the ones selected, Photoshop will only sample the color you initially click on, regardless of how many other colors you drag over. As long as you keep your mouse button held down, this option works best for coloring hair and other fine edges. You can see desaturate effect added to only hair, not on his shirt. The tolerance settings determines how different a color can be from the sampled color for Photoshop to replace with the foreground color. Let's make photo to matte look with simple curve adjustment. Now with hue and saturation, we can change colors also, or you can use color replacement tool again to add different color to his shirt. In next tutorial, I will show how to change color with color replacement tool. Here is before and after. Let's see another example. Her bikini and skin tones are nearly same colors, even though with color replacement tool and its edge detection feature, it's a very easy task to create select to color effect. Here is before and after. Color replacement tool was such an easy and powerful tool to use. It's worth giving it a try before moving on to more advanced and time-consuming methods. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel to get all our Photoshop tutorial PSD file source freely. Download link available in description for this tutorial PSD. Post a comment, click thumbs up. Like and share videos with your friends. See you again in next tutorial.